When cooking rice, remember not to look under the lid so often. It's important to develop confidence in your skills because really, it will greatly show on the dish. There are several tricks in slicing onions. That is why we should let it simmer for a few minutes to ensure the flavors are infused. Just think of your husbands when you find yourselves preparing this. It should look colorful so your husbands...
I agree with her.
Cooks out there is to use soy sauce instead of salt because soy sauce can make the food look good and taste better. For the women who reign over their kitchens, make sure to use Maria's soy sauce.
Don't want to go. She's amazing.
It was a mistake on our part to let you go, but we are not number one for nothing. We do recognize the mistakes we make, like the major sponsor of your show, Golden Touch, has made Diana their endorser. And so we'd like to offer you and Miss Diana Benipayo this show. I think we both know that this will benefit Diana's career. I'm sure you'll agree we can definitely offer more to you than a small cable company could.
Does it lack flavor?
Not really. I think you're just scared. Sometimes you have to do what you really want. Don't think twice about putting in as much flavor as you want. Put what you think is right. You shouldn't think anymore. Why, Louis? Do I have something in my teeth?
No. Well, you just got me thinking. I probably am scared.
Reed, you'll get a bigger talent fee with a bigger network. You should seriously consider this, Diana. This is what we've been dreaming of. We're finally going to be successful.
But Sophia, what about Louis? We are indebted to him for all of this.
Her show will air daily on the other network. I'm the producer. They're giving us full control as long as the ratings are good. The format is a little different. Lifestyle and talk show merged. And they also have a bigger budget.
I'm sorry, Sophia, but honestly, I really can't match their offer.
So, I guess no hard feelings.
Louis, are you mad at me?
Why would I be mad at you? This is for you. I'm actually happy. Because I know that this is a good opportunity for you.
Thank you, Louis. But you know what? I'm kind of sad. And a bit scared. What if they're not as nice as you are?
You know, they can't be mean to you over there. You're a queen. By the way, I finally got the right mixture. Thank you. I won't wish you good luck, because I know you don't need it. Don't be scared or nervous. Even if I make it to the opening of your show, they might not let me visit you in the dressing room. And I won't be able to help you calm your nerves.
Next time, it's my turn to cook for you.
Okay, I have to go.
Louis? Thank you so much.
Diana, how does it feel that just after 1 year you were able to create your new line of clothing and your
your show is a top rater, plus endorsers are lining up to get your support.
I can't express how honored and flattered and grateful I am for all the blessings that have come our way, especially to the many viewers who watch my show regularly. And I'm really hoping and praying that just as many people support our clothing line, Soyana Garments.
Excuse me, Margaret. How does it feel to be modeling at such a young age?
Smile, Margaret.
It's okay, I guess. I'm just a little overwhelmed because I'm not used to all the attention I'm getting right now.
Margaret, what are you doing here?
Shh, come over here. Sit down beside me, they might see you.
Hey, why are you hiding from them?
Well, it's Sheila. She's always pestering me, asking all these questions about Mother. You know, I wish we could just hide among the clouds, where I am sure we won't be found, and we also won't be bothered.
Studies that have been made, it would be best if we could plant alternative crops to ensure a year-round livelihood. We can plant yams, peanuts, and sweet potatoes.
Yeah, sure. You kids and your ideas. You all say the same thing. You're exactly like the other students who came here last year for the immersion. Don't you think that we already know what you're suggesting? But wait, let me ask you this. Where do you suggest that we get these root crops?
Exactly. The government, sir. They do provide a subsidy.
Have you spoken to anyone in the government? Have you seen a government office or perhaps a government official anywhere nearby? You know, things are just different around here, my dear. If I were you, I would open my eyes and look closely at what's going on around me. It seems your eyes are much too small to notice anything, though.
Oh my goodness, I don't believe this. Counting the days till we get out of here. I don't understand why they have to force us to mingle with the less fortunate. We even have to live in their shack-like houses. I hate being poor, and I hate this place.
I think it's nice here. It's quiet.
Precisely why I hate it. It's too quiet. You can hear all sorts of creepy sounds at night. And you know, Michael was telling me that just the other night, he heard some kind of shuffling sound outside his window. But when he went to look, there was no one there. But when he got back in bed, he heard it again. So he took another look. And can you just guess what he saw? He saw a pair of footprints leading away towards the hills. And those footprints, they don't look human.
Michael was probably just trying to scare you.
get seed. Come on, everyone. Let's see. Don't be shy. Come on. Go get some more food.
Oh my gosh, Margaret. Look at yourself. You're eating like a slob. Well, I'm hungry.
Hey, give me some fish, huh?
And you really think that they'll listen to you just because you act like them? Dream on, girl. They don't like us. Or haven't you noticed? They don't even want to talk to us.
And how do you expect them to talk to you when you belittle them?
Excuse me? I don't have to do anything. And I don't even have to befriend these people because, first and foremost, unlike you, I didn't volunteer for this. And you should stop acting superior, as if you're any better. You'll soon give up. I'll give you a week, and I'm sure you'll want to leave this place too.
I'm really enjoying it here, Mother, so don't worry about me. But what about you?
Well, you know, nothing has changed. As usual, I'm busy.
I really, really miss you, though.
I miss you a lot, too. What about Aunt Sophia? How is she?
Does she suspect anything?
Don't worry. She doesn't suspect a thing. I hate to go, but they're waiting for me at the studio.
Just take good care of yourself, and I love
you very, very, very much.
I love you too, Mother. Goodbye. A monster in the hills.
What? I knew it. I told you. This is a ghost town.
Are you sure, Margaret? You might have just seen a strange animal. Or maybe you were just more tired than usual today.
No, Grandfather. I know what I saw. At first I thought it was a man, but then he looked like he wanted to eat me.
Margaret, calm down. It might just have been your imagination.
No, it's not. I believe it's true. We should get out of this place now.
His face looked, well, one side looked... It looked burned, and his eyes were really scary, and I just don't know.
His face was burned, you say? Just half of his face?
Yes, ma'am. Oh. Haven't you ever heard stories about a monster around here, or haven't you seen anything? Because it really was a monster. And isn't anyone afraid of walking near the hills? I'm sure it's the creature that's been eating your crops, or even your people.
Of course not. Don't worry about it, okay?
I believe there really is a monster here. I called my mom, Margaret. She's going to have me picked up soon. And I really don't care if the school requires me to stay. I don't. I'm really leaving this place.
Hey, look here, all of you. My son received honors. See? intelligent son of mine. He'll make sure that we rise out of this poverty. Mr. Fernando will never push us around and take advantage of us. Never.
How can you be so sure of yourself, huh?
And why shouldn't I be? No one else around here has achieved what Harry has. And who else would he take after, huh? He takes after me. And when Harry graduates from college, he'll stop at nothing to make us rich.
And let's pray it happens soon, like tomorrow!
That's the best part.
Is that Harry?
Who is that? I haven't seen him around here before.
Oh, who cares, Margaret? I don't get why you're so interested in these people.
Wait here, okay? I want to look. He seems so popular around here.
Oh, Margaret!
See that? Look, there.
Are you okay? Riding a caravel.
She's one of the students who's been sent here to do research for her school.
For research again? What are we to them, Father? Guinea pigs? But Father, they haven't even done anything to help us. All they really do is talk. They just bring false hopes to the community, but nothing ever happens.
Son, they're really good people. Some of them even brought us corned beef. It's actually nice to have
Mother,
them around.
Mother, we're just subjects to be observed for their research papers. To get a grade in class. And the canned goods they bring? Who really knows if those things are still edible?
Harry, just let them be. There are worse people out there. Take the case of that Mr. Fernando. He's a greedy man. Can you believe that he filed another petition in court claiming that our land is his? Of course, we're not going to let him get away with it.
Father, what if something bad happens to you?
Of course not. The deed to the land is in our name. They can't do anything about it. So, son, don't worry about it, okay?
You know, I really feel bad about what I said before. Ma'am Ising and Mr. Cadio might think I'm bad-mouthing Harry. But I didn't know. Do you think he could have recognized me? I hope not. I'm so embarrassed.
It's not as if you were wrong about what you said. If I saw him that night, I would have thought exactly the same thing. Did you see his face? I think it must have been burned by acid or something. It's so yuck!
You don't have to be so mean. He looks like a nice person.
You're calling me mean? I wasn't the one who called him a monster in front of all the other people.
But I didn't do it intentionally.
Just make sure to scrub hard to get the mud out, okay?
Mm-hmm. Yes,
well,
ma'am.
So we can sell it at a good price. Hey,
good
Harry!
Good morning, Ma'am Ising.
How are you?
I'm so good. Gross. You know, ma'am, you seem to be getting younger each and every single time I see you.
You flatter me, Harry. Oh, but an old woman knows better than that. Oh, have you met our visitors?
Oh, not yet.
Oh, this is Chrissy.
Hello.
Hi.
Over there is Rochelle. And that's Michael.
Harry.
And Margaret.
Oh. It's a little difficult to forget people who talk about monsters and spread all sorts of ghoulish tales around town.
Harry. I'm so sorry.
Ma'am Ising, I'll come back another time. I don't feel well all of a sudden. I'll see you.
Okay.
Hi, Harry. I brought some food here for you and your mother and father.
Why?
No reason. Actually, I just wanted to apologize for how I reacted when I first ran into you. I really didn't mean to insult you like I did.
We don't need any food from you. And to be honest, we don't need any kind of help from you.
Bye, Mr. Fernando.
homework. Oh, Gemma, please make sure to tell Lita to come to class tomorrow so he can catch up on his lessons, okay? All right, see you tomorrow.
Please, Margaret, if they don't want to come, don't force them. We're volunteering to teach them for free, and then they don't show up. It's so rude.
Okay, so put the basket down for a while.
Actually,
I'm tired too.
This
really is quite heavy. Margaret, you can put that down over here.
Hey, wait. Harry! Harry, can you help us carry this stuff here? Our baskets are so heavy!
Okay, just there.
Whoa! Hold it. Just a minute.
Harry, we need a hand here. Would you
know
these heavy baskets
yes, ma'am.
Here, Harry?
Okay, sure. Don't worry, I've got it.
And these two.
No, it's okay. I'll do it.
Okay, up to you. Is that everything?
Oh, there's just one more over there. Thank you so much, Harry.
Oh, don't mention it.
Thank you so much.
Hey!
Margaret! Oh, are you all right?
Girl!
Oh, are you hurt? Oh, my goodness. Are you okay?
Good to me from now on, okay? Don't humiliate me anymore, okay? Please? Come on.
Hey, Margaret! How are you? Are you still in pain from your fall? Are you just going to ignore me? You know your eyes get smaller when you're angry. Be careful or they might disappear completely. Oh. Are you planning on riding it? Aren't you scared that you might fall off that beast again?
Why would I ride on it when I can just pull it instead? Excuse me. Don't play too rough out there, okay?
Don't tell me that after you taught that carabao to follow you around that you expect these kids to do the same. You're not Pied Piper, Chinky Eyes.
My name is not Chinky Eyes, and I certainly don't see these children that way. I just really want them to learn.
To learn? And you're going to teach them? They usually send students like you out here to make up for flunking a subject.
For your information, I volunteered to come. And I don't need to do this to get good grades.
So you're here because you're bored hanging out in that palace of yours in the city, right? That's good. You can learn a lot from this place to help you pass all your subjects in school.
You're so full of yourself. And you think you're so intelligent? Well, I'm smart too, but I don't live in a palace back home.
No, you're confused. I'm the smart one who doesn't own a palace. And you're the wealthy girl, clueless about the world.
Just what exactly do you have against the rich? And why are you so convinced that I am rich and stupid? You're so quick to judge people.
You want to know something? If you actually just used your brain, you know what a brain is. It's that mass inside your head that lies between your cute little ears. If you use that, you'll notice that you don't belong here. And you should just go home.
You know what? I really didn't want to say this to you. But the truth is, your ugly face matches perfectly with your ugly personality. Are you sure you want to stay here? Yes, I'm sure. I still have to help Miss Ford with the report she has to finish.
That's good.
Drive safely, guys. Bye.
Bye, darling.
Bye, Brian.
Bye.
Take care.
You know what? He's so beyond conceited. He's arrogant. More than a few times, I swallowed my pride for him.
I already apologized, and I even brought food over to his house.
And I even offered to help out when I saw that he looked exhausted from working.
And then, guess what? Guess what he called me?
He called me a stupid rich kid.
Aren't you heading home soon? So you really don't have to worry anymore.
Hey, it looks like you guys are enjoying yourselves over here.
Hi, Harry. We're just sharing and enjoying the goods given to us by the students before they left for the city.
That's right.
Want some?
The can open.
Oh, so they left already?
They're on the way home, Harry. Give me some hot dogs, will you?
Well, that's good, right? That means we can enjoy some peace and quiet around here.
Yes,
that's right.
Hey, hey.
Ma'am Karing, $10 worth of kerosene, please.
Okay, at least give me two. Oh, this is good.
I'm staying here a while longer.
You decided to stay?
Yes, because Miss Four says that there's still a lot to do around here that needs her attention. And I really want to help her out because
she's doing it alone.
Is Miss Four really the reason you're staying, huh?
Definitely, definitely.
You know, even if I'm far away, I can sense that you're not being truthful.
All right, already. The truth is I'm so annoyed with that Harry person.
I need to prove to him that he's wrong about his bad notions of me.
It looks like my best friend is starting to develop feelings for a certain young man.
Stephanie, excuse me, but there's just no way I'm falling for a really arrogant, ill-mannered, self-obsessed person who is, I hate to say it, is an ugly person.
No way, no.
What do you mean, no? Stop trying to kid yourself.
I really don't. He's a different kind of species.
Yes, he is different. Because you've
never spent so much time obsessing over any guy as much as you have about Harry.
Stephanie, oh please, don't you dare.
Even as a joke, don't say stuff like that.
Oh, sure, Margaret. Yeah.
How dare you, Diana, blatantly lie to me like that?
Wait, Sophia, let me explain.
Let me explain? I already know everything. And to think that I canceled all of the appointments for Margaret and her print ad photo shoot, for what?
The only reason I told you she was on a retreat
was... You both lied to me and made me think and believe it was a retreat. And all along it was for that stupid immersion. Damn that immersion, and damn you for lying to me, Diana.
Calm down, Sophia. I had to tell you that because I know you would not have allowed for Margaret.
I absolutely would not have allowed it, and there's a valid reason for it. Haven't you learned anything from what we've been through? Huh? Sometimes you just don't think. People who aren't famous get kidnapped. You think Margaret's safe out there? If something bad happens to her, I have no one to blame but you.
Students came to class today.
Oh, Margaret, it looks like someone is trying to take over your teaching post.
Okay, children, who wants to read out loud for us today? Who has a loud, clear voice so everyone can hear? Hey, you do it, Marielle.
I'm sorry, but I wasn't able to bring my book because I lent it to Lito. But he didn't come to class today, which is why I don't have a book to use.
Oh, that's all right. Here, you can use my copy instead.
Are you doing this on purpose?
I thought you left already.
I don't want to hear your stupid, flimsy, made-up excuses.
What exactly is your problem, Chinky Eyes?
Why did you steal my class away from me?
Steal your class? I think I told you before, right? Children are not like Carabao. They wouldn't just follow me if they really didn't want to. Maybe they just didn't like the way you were teaching them.
Fine. Okay. You really are brilliant.
Well, thank goodness you finally spoke the truth.
Huh?
And what do you think you're doing?
If you really are brilliant, then that means I should learn from you. So go ahead and teach.
So you want to behave this way, do you? Okay, let's just see how long you last. Do you plan on following me everywhere?
Why, can't you take it anymore? You know, I'm actually a quick study, and I think I should learn from the master.
Do what you want.
You're really something else. You deliberately walked all over town pretending to make all these trips just to torture me.
I wouldn't let you down. So, have you been practicing what I taught you?
Yes, I have. I can already write my name. If you want, I can show you.
That's very good. Well, shall we continue practicing?
Come on in.
Okay. Well, were you able to take down notes for your research paper?
Almost got you.
If you're willing to teach the kids around here, why would you prevent me from teaching them? I just want to help like you do.
The difference between us is I'm sincere.
But I'm sincere too.
Really? If you're really sincere, then you should get to know the kids. You should know what they go through and experience every day. But I don't even think you know all the names of these children.
Louis hasn't been able to go to school because he helps his handicapped father who sells bamboo for a living. Liwei, on the other hand, at such a young age, washes clothes for money to help put her siblings through college. And Carla takes care of her ailing mother because her father passed away from bone cancer and only has her to depend on. Do you want me to go on?
Father.
Hey, son. You're still up? It's kind of late.
Oh, I was trying to take in some fresh air, since I couldn't really sleep.
Oh, and who is it you're thinking about, if I may ask?
Oh, no one.
I understand, son. I've been kept awake thinking about girls during my time. Well, you better go to bed. It's late. Night, son.
She tells me that she feels so fat, but that doesn't stop her from eating like a pig.
Did you eat that much?
Huh? And what did your mother have to say?
Yes.
Who was it? Who slept earlier? Did they get hurt? I can help you with your homework later.
Okay.
Son, are you still thinking about what happened to you and Lisa?
But Father, she was right about what she said. It's true that I'm ugly. My only mistake was in believing that she might actually fall for me.
Not all girls are like that, Harry. I'm quite sure that the girl you're starting to have feelings for now isn't like that. That's probably why you've developed feelings for her. It's because she's nice. Am I right?
Who are you talking about, Father?
Son, even if you don't talk about her, I know you're starting to fall for our visitor, the girl from the city.
Are you talking about Margaret? Are you kidding me, Father?
Not at all.
She's really wealthy. We don't belong to the same social class. And I'm very sure she won't ever go for someone like me.
Will you stop talking like that? You're good, hardworking, and very intelligent.
I really don't want to hope, Father. I'm aware that nothing can ever happen between us. And that's the honest-to-goodness truth. Don't let those kids get attached to you. We both know that you're going to leave them soon to go back home. So just please look for another place to hang out. This is my spot. This is my home.
Understand my line of reasoning. Louis, am I wrong to want my daughter to be happy? Was what I did wrong?
You weren't wrong, Diana.
Sophia had a point too. She was right about what she said. And now I feel like I'm the most irresponsible mother. Was it a mistake to have allowed her to go on that trip? Louis, am I such a bad mother?
Wait a minute. Stop. Don't let your anger out in these onions. Huh? Look at what happened. You're all teary-eyed. Chopping onions doesn't seem to be good for you. I'll handle the chopping. Starting today, you're not allowed to chop onions when you're angry, okay? Look at it. They've been shred to bits. And don't worry about Margaret. I'm sure she's having the time of her life.
That's wonderful, but don't forget, school is not just about fun and games. It's not just about singing and rhyming. You need to take your studies seriously too, okay?
Give me some of that. Come on, let's eat.
Yeah? Excuse me, guys, okay? Hey, you jinky eyes, what was it again that you were singing earlier? How did it go? One times one, Magellan. Two times two, Labu.
You know what? I've had it with you. What exactly do you want to prove?
Why don't you two just get a room?
Yeah, come on.
Go on.
You see, Margaret, what I really, really want is for you to just leave. Those kids, they don't need you at all. You're just gonna hurt them. You fill their heads with stories about your world until that's all they think and dream about. That's all they want for themselves. Until it becomes their only goal. But is it all worth it? You, will you stay here to mold them? To guide and help all of them achieve their goals? You won't, right?
I'm not leaving here just because you want me to. And I will not allow you to scare me off that easily just because you're older than I am and just because you're a man.
Ooh, sounds like a challenge, Harry. She claims she can do everything you can do. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. What is it that you can do? You can't even hold your liquor.
Hey, wait, 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 wait. Why don't we give them a glass each? Huh? Let's see who gets drunk faster. Yeah, go ahead, pour them a shot each. That's it.
Yeah, come on. Give her a drink.
All right, Harry. They've evened it up. Come on.
See that? She's just a girl.
Yeah, don't tell you
can take her.
Come on. Oops, oops.
No.
Let's just leave them be.
Don't tell me a little girl's gonna beat you.
If I win this, you will do everything I ask without complaining.
Sure. But if I win, Margaret, you have to leave.
Okay.
All right, start.
Ready, Harry?
One, two,
three.
Harry, you're gonna be sick. You okay, man?
Come on, drink up.
Come on.
What?
Come on, Harry.
What's wrong with you?
Handle it.
I'm going home soon. I'm really glad you called. You better hurry up and get home. I can't believe I lost our bet. This is not a bet. My mother already knows that you did not go to a retreat. You know, I really can't understand what's causing this animosity. Well, you've been caught lying. Mother learned the truth at the school when she went to give a donation.
But you know,
even if we're fighting, I still don't want to leave this place. Because over here, I feel free. Not like at home. I always have to do what Aunt Sophia says. But because I lost that stupid bet, I have to leave and go back home.
Margaret, are you listening to me? My mother already knows...
Is that Margaret?
Hey, son. Still thinking about her? Listen, son. It is not good to deny what's in your heart. There's just no way that your brain can dictate what your heart feels. No matter how hard you try to suppress those feelings, it just won't work, son. Let me give you a piece of advice, son. You are still a young man. Don't try to rush into anything. Take your time. Okay? Good night.